Today we are gathered here to remember and honor the life of Sergeant John Hugg. On behalf of the 860th Military Police Company, the 850th Military Police Battalion, thanks for being in attendance here today. Let us pray. Almighty God, you are the Father of mercy and the giver of peace. On behalf of a grateful nation, we are proud to honor and remember one of our own. As we pause to thank you for this life lived, we also pray for peace and comfort for those who remain. We ask that you comfort and heal them in this difficult time. It is in your holy and precious name we pray. Amen.
Sergeant Hugg was, without a doubt, the nicest man I've ever met in my time in the Army. Every time I was on KP, it was a fun experience. It was never a punishment to be on KP, because Sergeant Hugg made sure you were doing what you were supposed to, but never without a smile on your face. And the best part about him was he's one of the few people in the company I could talk to about hockey with. Talk about it every drill. He was, nothing made him happier. Except his kids, of course. Told me all about his kids. And it was never a sad moment with him in the kitchen. So thank you for sharing Sergeant Hugg with us, because it was an honor to know him, and he'll be missed.
The loss of Sergeant Hugg this past week has been filled with a whirlwind of emotions for the 860th MP Company. Sergeant Hugg was an optimist and always wanting to help. He was a consistent positive force within the company. There are three things for soldiers that you don't mess with: their pay, their time, and their food. Sergeant Hugg took this to heart, and we all knew that. He was proud of his shop and the dedication to the unit, and this is obvious in the work that they all did with his leadership. I'm sure we can all agree that as soon as Sergeant Hugg became part of our family, Jack in the Box got a lot less busy over drill weekends. He was a breed of soldier that is pretty scarce. Let it be remembered that Sergeant Hugg joined purely to serve his nation after the events of 9/11. Not for bonuses, not for benefits, simply to serve selflessly. He was a man that wanted to do his part in avenging those who had died during the attacks. And as we continue our service, I challenge you all to do the same in remembrance of Sergeant Hugg. Come to drill with a positive attitude and a desire to make the difference, just like he did. There's a genuine void with his absence this weekend, but know that he truly loved working with all of you. Before I close my remarks, I want to bring to the attention that he was a father of five, two of which are currently both under the age of 18. I can't imagine what they're feeling right now, but I have reassured his family that we are available to provide any support that they might need during this hard time. If needed, I expect all of us to answer the call. Out of respect for Sergeant Hugg, check on your battle buddies and support those who might need your help, because you know he would have done the same for all of you. Bless those who serve our nation. Godspeed, brother. We've got it from here. Reaper's Ride.
Sergeant Hugg was one of the most positive people you could ever meet in your life, in the military-wise at least. There was always times where, like, I'd just be randomly passing by doing something, and he'd always say, "Hey, Broyles, how's it going?" Or, you know, he'd say it to other soldiers, just always cheering everybody up. I never knew Sergeant Hugg to be someone who was, I ever saw down in the dumps, or, you know, someone who had a bad attitude. You know, whether we were out in the field and it was cold or rainy or whatever, he's always there with the food, and you could tell he really enjoyed what he did, and, you know, it definitely was appreciated by us, you know, the soldiers at least. He's very complimentary, and he never forgot your name once he knew it. He's definitely one of the most inspirational cooks that we've ever had, and he will be missed.
Excuse me, I had to cut a few things out of here just to kind of narrow it down to how I could explain John Hugg. I've known him since February 2016. In that short time, he made an impression on me and my family. Seeing him the day before each drill and setting up made sure that he and his team were successful. Having him call from Papago after each drill to confirm his numbers with Master Sergeant Hill and Chief Ham, he ensured that each drill was a mission success. That's who Sergeant Hugg was. taking over an E7 position on a short notice and executing with passion and commitment to his duty. He would be running from one place to another and stop by to offer money to help with the FRG, stating, "Oh no, I don't mind, just put it towards the unit." He always set aside time to come in to my office each drill with a plate made knowing that I hadn't eaten yet. He'd ask if my soldiers would want seconds. I'd be staying late after each drill. And a lot of you guys would know this if you see me after drill. He'd come in and we'd talk about life, politics, baseball, anything other than work. It was relieving. He always had time for his soldiers. He knew them well, and he took care of them. He took them in as family. He had their back, and they had theirs. And they had his. And that's who John was, loyal and compassionate. He would truly be missed, a man of honor and respect, a man of kindness and friendliness. His happiness was contagious. And the 860th MP family will feel his loss for a very long time. Yesterday, Captain Leon told us that they were going to dedicate the kitchen in his name. It seems right. He spent so many of the hours in that ugly kitchen, cooking his heart out for the 860th family. We appreciate the gesture, a way to remember him, and a way to have John's memory here at the 860th, looking over the kitchen and, of course, his soldiers. To his children and family, please accept my sincere condolences. You always have a place with us. Sergeant Hug, you are the true meaning of what it takes to be an NCO and a friend. Till we meet again.
Sergeant Hug, I was devastated when I heard you left us. I remember the first time I met, we never saw eye to eye. And then we clicked on our deployment. Out of nowhere, it was a great time to be with you and serve with you. And then years later, we meet again. And it was a whole new you and a whole new me. And it was like we were best friends again. But it hurts. Yesterday when we did our PT test, it was like you were right there running with me. I could see you there yelling, "Hey, good job, John." And I replied, "You too, John." And you'll be greatly missed.
John Thomas Hug was born on August 9th, 1964 to Ralph and Helen Hug in Council Bluffs, Iowa, and passed away on October 11th, 2019. He was the second of five children that included three brothers, Marty, Jim, and Tim, and he had a sister named Amy. John attended Thomas Jefferson High School, graduating in 1982. He excelled in sports including wrestling, football, track, and swimming. Following high school, John worked as a journeyman electrician, later entering the car business as a salesman and eventually being promoted to financing. In 2000, John relocated to Phoenix, Arizona, where he worked in public transit with the city of Tempe. John was an avid sports fan, particularly the Arizona professional teams. He followed the Diamondbacks and Coyotes, of which he attended games whenever possible. John had a strong respect and passion for the military and those who served. Following the events of 9/11, he joined the Naval Reserves. Transferring to the Army National Guard in 2003, he trained at Fort Bliss, Texas. In 2006, John was deployed to Iraq in support of Operation Iraqi Freedom. Following his deployment, he returned to Arizona where he continued to serve until his passing, attaining the rank of sergeant. As an NCO, he always led by example and ensured that his soldiers were taken care of. His commitment to hard work, dependability, and dedication made him a valuable asset to the team and to the organization. Stronger than John's passion for the military service was his love, devotion, and commitment to faith and family. John was a proud father of five children, Amanda, Josh, Megan, Grace, and Emily. He was proud of his children and loved them dearly. He enjoyed spending time with them, traveling to see them, and having them come visit him here. He also was close to his parents, siblings, and extended family. He was also a student of faith. As a believer, he was committed to knowing God. He and I had numerous conversations about theology, contemporary social issues, and scripture. What will always stand out to me is his desire to serve others. He always wanted to know how he can help and how he can serve those at any capacity. Jesus said, "The Son of Man did not come to be served, but to serve and give his life as a ransom for many." In keeping with the army value of selfless service, John embodied that. John was loved by many. He was quick to give a compliment, provide support to those who need it, give all he had for others. His passing leaves a void that will be difficult to fill. The psalmist tries to seek us comfort in the 23rd Psalm. It says, "The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in paths of righteousness for his namesake. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever." There are three things that I think just speaks to John and who he was. The first thing is John had a relationship with God. Just like the psalmist, the Lord was his shepherd. The Lord is the one that guided and directed him. And no matter what he faced, he always experienced firsthand the presence of God. And my prayer for you and my prayer for the family is that God's presence would be with you as you go through this extremely difficult time. And the third thing is, which is the encouragement, is to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. And I know where John is right now because of his faith. He will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. So we can take great courage and comfort in knowing where John is right now. For those of us that knew and loved Sergeant Hug, may we set aside today to remember and honor our brave brother in arms and never forget the impact he made on all of us. I would like to close my remarks with a poem. It is entitled, "It is the Soldier." It is the soldier, not the minister, who has given us freedom from religion. It is the soldier, not the reporter, who has given us freedom from press. It is the soldier, not the poet, who has given us freedom of speech. It is the soldier, not the campus organizer, who has given us freedom to protest. It is the soldier, not the lawyer, who has given us a right to a fair trial. It is the soldier, not the politician, who has given us the right to vote. It is the soldier who salutes the flag, who serves beneath the flag, and whose coffin is draped by the flag, who allows the protester to burn the flag. Let us never forget the sacrifices made for our freedoms. Sergeant Hug was one of us, and he should be honored and remembered as such. Sergeant Hug, may you rest in peace.
I'm here as one of the lower enlisted guys. Just wanted to reach out and say how much my heart really dropped when I heard the news last week. Being friends with Nathaniel for so many years, his nephew, I really felt for him, and I just remember Sergeant Hug always had such an uncanny ability to make people feel better. A lot of the times, even I got in trouble, I was sent to him, and he always made sure to pick people up. And you know, me and him really got along and connected on our love of the same music, a lot of the old classic country. And I always remember him telling me how much he loved Drake. He didn't like modern music, but he loved Drake. So that's always funny to me. But there's things he told me, he taught me, and I'll carry for the rest of my life. And he taught me some good lessons, and you know, he won't be forgotten anytime soon. So I'm happy for the time I got to spend with him while he was here, and I'm gonna be sad he's gone forever. So it was tough, but
Sergeant Hug was the epitome of a selfless service soldier. He took care of his troops. He took care of everybody in the company. He made sure everybody else was good to go before he was even good to go. He was always that smiling face that everybody saw. He was just a great soldier all around. He's going to be greatly missed. He was like the Papa Bear of the company, because anybody could go to him. And he always had good things to say, regardless of what situation was going on. I never heard him talk negatively about anybody or anything that was going on in the company. He made it a point to come and talk to me about certain soldiers that were helping him out in KP and in the kitchen. And he told me how great of a job they were doing, and he was appreciative for everything. He's just an all-around good guy, and he's going to be very missed.
Today we honor Sergeant John Hugg, our brother whom we mourn for his sudden passing. Sergeant John Hugg's passion to serve was evident. His care for his soldiers, immensely noticeable. His personality infectious with positivity. He never shied away from bringing up concerns to the leadership on behalf of the soldiers and unit. He dedicated much of his time outside of drill to check on soldiers and ensure food services were squared away. What the 850th MP Battalion will miss most about Sergeant John Hugg will be his unique way of bringing old school thought to the changes of the Army and society. He always provided his two cents in which he thought, but always asked the right questions when needed. He had a balance that was great for his soldiers of the 860th MP Company. His eyes gleamed bright when it came to each and every soldier of the Reaper's Ride. The Command Sergeant Major and I grieve and mourn with you and his family. Sergeant Hugg served with the utmost pride. He would want each and every one of us to continue the mission, live the Army values, and make an everlasting impression on someone else's life as he has done with all of us. In closing, to honor Sergeant Hugg, on behalf of each and every member of the 850th MP Battalion, we present this plaque, which is to be placed outside the 860th's kitchen. And it reads, in honor of Sergeant John Hugg, Food Services NCOIC, 860th Military Police Company, Hugg's Kitchen.
So I just wanted to say and pay my respects and pass my condolences out to the family of Sergeant Hugg. He's going to be missed. He's a great person, great personality. It was always great to come around here, work with him, and you know, see him bring a smile to everybody. Awesome person. Everybody that I've ever spoke to or has known him, even people that I talked to about this issue when it happened, couldn't believe what had happened, and everybody was really sad to say. And the one thing that everybody always brought up was what a nice guy he was, and you know how much he was doing for everybody. So we're really gonna miss him here, and much respect and condolences out to everyone. And I can only imagine what you guys are going through. So our prayers are with you. Thank you.
Let us pray. Gracious Heavenly Father, may you bless us and keep us. May you make your face shine upon us and be gracious to us. May you turn your face toward us and give us peace. In your holy and precious name we pray. Amen. At this time, we will render final honors.
He's got a corner lot on Dogwood Drive. A year old truck and a 9-to-5 comes home at night to a pretty wife with a baby due. He'll sleep in on Saturday. Cut the grass if it don't rain. After church, he'll watch the game and have a beer or two. He'll stand up when he hears the anthem, and that won't ever change. He's still a soldier. His blood runs red, white, and blue. He put away his gun and boots, but he still believes the American dream. His last breath, he'll always be a soldier. He's still a soldier. He's on his couch for the news at 10. He'll see those places that he's been. And when a brother falls, there's a part of him that does too. If they call and needed him back, all he'd be on that plane. He's still a soldier. His blood runs red, white, and blue. He put away his gun and boots, but he still believes
the American dream. To his last breath, he'll always be a soldier.
Shut the door. You crossed the sea to fight a war. You didn't know just what would happen to you. Stepped in the dirt, boots on the ground, and gunfire was the only sound. And to yourself, you whispered, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Drive on, first platoon.
Drive on, first platoon.
Drive on, first platoon.
Drive on, first platoon.
Someday you'll be all alone.
Someday you'll be all alone.
Way out in a combat zone.
Way out in a combat zone.
Bullets flying all around.
Bullets flying all around.
Better keep your head to the ground.
Better keep your head to the ground.
Don't you worry about being alone.
Don't you worry about being alone.
Second platoon will bring you home.
Second platoon will bring you home.
Drive on, second platoon.
Drive on, second platoon.
Drive on, second platoon.
Drive on, second platoon.
Someday you'll be all alone.
Someday you'll be all alone.
Way out in a combat zone.
Way out in a combat zone.
Bullets flying all around.
Bullets flying all around.
Better keep your head to the ground.
Better keep your head to the ground.
Don't you worry about being alone.
Don't you worry about being alone.
Third platoon will bring you home.
Third platoon will bring you home.
Drive on, third platoon.
Drive on, third platoon.
Drive on, third platoon.
Drive on, third platoon.
Don't you worry about being alone.
Don't you worry about being alone.
Way out there in a combat zone.
Way out there in a combat zone.
Bullets flying all around.
Bullets flying all around.
Better keep your head to the ground.
Better keep your head to the ground.
Don't you worry about being alone.
Don't you worry about being alone.
All your buddies will bring you home.
All your buddies will bring you home.
Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again. Because a vision softly creeping left its seeds while I was sleeping. And the vision that was planted in my brain still remains within the sound of silence. In restless dreams I walked alone. Narrow streets of cobblestone, neath the halo of a street lamp, I turned my collar to the cold and damp. When my eyes were stared by the flash of a neon light, it split the night. Touch the sound of silence. And in the naked light I saw 10,000 people, maybe more. People talking without speaking. People hearing without listening. People writing songs and voices never shared, and no one dared disturb the sound of silence. Fool said I, you do not know. Silence like a cancer grows. Hear my words and I might teach you.